For coming, my name is José Manuel Ortega. I'm from Spain. This is my second time here in Bayside in Manchester. The first time I was here was 2 years ago, talking about Docker security. In my personal GitHub page, you can find other security or conferences that I made related with security in Docker, Python, for example. I use Python very much for pen testing and so on. Also, in my personal YouTube channel, you can find other security conferences related with Node.js, for example, Python and OSINT, testing Python security. All these topics are covered in this channel. Well, also I like writing about security, and with PAC editorial I have published some books related with Python security. The first one is Python for Networking and Security, that covers topic from building a network to different processes you need to follow to security than detecting vulnerabilities in servers and web applications. And the second one is learning Python networking. This covers topics like socket programming, how to design servers in event-driven architectures, and asynchronous programming with Async IO, Tornado, all these frameworks available in Python. And other topics related with server administration with Ansible. And also there is an introduction to web applications, for example with Django and Flash frameworks, and scrapping techniques with Scrappy and Scrapping Hub, that are the most known frameworks for Python. Well, this is the main points of the talk. This time basically I'm going to focus especially in how to discover hidden services and Python modules for getting information from the tunnel work. And also I will review some of OSINT tools, open source intelligence tools, for getting information from specific onion sites from the Tor network. Well, when we are talking about the Tor, when we are introducing Tor, for example, we have this perspective. We have the surface web. This is the internet as we know it, like search engines and public sites. In the second level, we have the deep, in the second and third, we have the deep and the dark web. And basically, it's all internet content that is not indexed by traditional search engines. At this point, we can also include sites that are restricted by user credentials, as well as specific database and private documents. Basically, these two levels represent the part of the web that has not been indexed by common search engine. Dark web is part of a deep web that cannot access via normal browsers. There are three major dark web technologies. They are the Tor network, H2P, and Freenet. And in this talk, I'm going to center in the Tor. Tor is basically the most popular and most active technology. Well, what is Tor? Basically, Tor is a privacy preserving technology with two distinct purposes. The first one is to hide the locations of users. Every time you connect to a website, that website locates you IP address that can be traced back to your internet service provider. And basically Tor encrypts part of the communication, not all the communications, but the part of the communication encrypts your browsing traffic using a technique called onion routing. that hides your IP address from the website you visit. And the second purpose of this technology is to hide the traffic from your internet service provider, who can see where you are connected to the Tor network, but cannot determine what sites you are accessing in the Tor network. Tor provides a method of anonymity by passing data between proxies. For example, we could access WikiLeaks from Tor network instead using the surface web. It's very common to access these sites using the Tor network instead of using the surface web, because provides anonymity and all the communications based between proxies, machine proxies, relays, and so on. Later we will see the Tor architecture, how the communication is established between your between the client and the server. Tor proposed the use of onion routing. Basically, message travel from the origin to the destination in an encrypted way through a series of special routers called onion routers. And each onion router remove a layer of encryption to uncover routing instructions and sends the message to the next router where this is repeated. This prevents these intermediary nodes from knowing the origin, destination, and context of the message. Well, this is a first view of the Tor network, how the Tor client connects to the Tor and the Tor network. We have established what is called a circuit. A circuit, basically, in a circuit, when you establish the connection, the communication, we can find three types of nodes. The entry that connects with the Tor client, the entry one, the middle relay, and the exit node, the C relay. Entry nodes see the when a connection starts, intermediate or middle send information between nodes, always encrypt, and exits, the exit relays, are nodes for final unencrypted communication. The final communication between the last relay and the destination server is unencrypted. And in this case, it's possible to, in this case, the IP address is visible. The target of the destination servers, you are connected, only see the IP address of the exit relay. The exit node is called, while your connection is routed through other nodes within the Tor network. In a more technical way, basically, a Tor client obtains a list of Tor nodes from a Tor directory server. The directory server is one of the most important things in the Tor network. Basically, it's responsible to provide you with a complete list of nodes, list of servers that make up the Tor network. From that moment, your client will select pseudo-random routes and image connection to different sites of the network. In the step 2, we can see that Tor client picks a random path to a destination server, and the server is creates what is called a hidden service descriptor in the step 2. That is the file that contains the unknown address of the service, the public key, the private key, and all information. In the step 3, Tor client picks another random path to connect to a different destination server, and the client will obtain the public key of the service and the list of the repeaters, the server repeaters that function as introduction point to contact the hidden service. In the next step, the Tor client and the hidden service are met in this entry point called rendezvous point. This is the key of the anonymity. These servers are the key of the anonymity in Tor network, because there is no direct connection between the Tor client and the hidden service. All information, all the communication is established with a service called entry points in the that are called rendezvous points. And well, in this way, and the service now knows the location of the rendezvous point, the response to the client request, when the response returns to the client, will now pass through the circuits created. Instead, will be sent directly to this server. Well, the most important thing that we can see with Tor is the directory servers. As I commented before, the directory servers that we can see at this point, the directory server is the most important scene in this graphic. Provides the crucial information to raise the destination. And as I mentioned earlier, this node have databases with the list of the or relay servers, known and onion routers. Well, what is a hidden service? Well, basically, hidden service is a node in the Tor network with a web service which doesn't publish the IP address but publishers. But it publishes an onion address, which is known as by directory servers. According to the Tor project statistics, there are over 80,000 onion servers running at this time. We can see these statistics in this URL, in metrics.project.org. We can see these statistics. Now the question is, how can discover a hidden service and find its real location? Well, there are several services. For example, we can discover, for example, in a public way, we can obtain information, for example, the Tor node list. We can see that the space of possible onion addresses is so large that it's impossible to control the totality of possible hidden services that might exist in the Tor network. Many are not active all the time, and making it even more difficult to detect them. In this study, we can see some statistics about onion routers that are active in the Tor network in a specific time, but these statistics are very variable in the time. Tor status allows, for example, these two URLs. You can see the status of the network in real time. And show the repeaters, the servers that are active in together with a detail of each repeater, with information relative to the country, bandwidth, and operating system. Here, for example, we can see the top 10 of relay servers in the Tor network. We can see the bandwidth, the country, and some flags for detecting if the encryption and so on. There are other services like Exoneratore. A service maintains a database of IP addresses that have been part of the Tor network. Exonera Tor, for example, might store more than one IP address per relay. If relay use a different IP address for the exit to the internet, for example. The relay search, this URL provides a relay search in the Tor network. The relay search tool displays data about relays and bridges in the Tor network. This specific share engine provides usual information on how relays are configured. The bandwidth, country, and so on. We can get more info, details about relays, information about nickname, fingerprint, host name, country, and flags related with the node type. These are, for example, some of the for intrusion with for discover, for intrusion, undiscover, and starting, discover, hiding services. We can use, for example, these onion addresses for starting with this topic. Hiding wiki contains many links for get, for example, specific share engines in the Tor network, and so on. And there are other we will see specific share engines for obtain hidden services. For example, the hidden wiki provides a directory of links to other onion sites. It can be considered as the Wikipedia in the Tor network. Onion sites includes a way to anonymously publish any sort of service, wiki, blog, forum within the Tor network. The hidden wiki main page includes many links to many illegal advertisements such as drugs, gas, fraud, and hacking service. When we are connecting to the Tor network, we have many options. The first one is you don't want connect directly. You can use proxies. For example, Tor to Web provides a proxy to connect to the Tor network without connecting directly to the Tor network. Basically, it's a proxy to redirect .onion web traffic between the client and the server. The main problem with using this proxy is that cannot offer any anonymity for the user point of view. If you want at least anonymity, you have to use the Tor browser, for example. And for example, both this service and the hidden service itself can see the visitors' IP addresses and use browser fingerprinting techniques to target users across different sessions. From the user privacy point of view, it's better, for example, to use the Tor browser bundle that you can install in whatever operating system, Linux, Mac, Windows, for access the hidden services using Tor. Basically, Tor browser provides a way to manage the Tor relays, for establish a circuit, get new identity, and establish basically a new circuit between the browser and the Tor network. you are using, for example, a Tor browser, you will notice in the network or in the network configuration in your machine that you are connected to a SOX proxy in a specific port. Now I will comment in this aspect. Basically, you are using, for example, a Linux distribution, Debian or Ubuntu. Using the Tor network is as simple as installing the Tor client software, which basically acts as a SOX proxy for TCP connections. And with the default configuration, we can start the service. If we need special configurations, there are files called Tor.rc file. Special is the configuration file for connecting to the Tor network. By default, the Tor client is using the 9015 port for SOX traffic. And controlling the Tor client is possible by configuring this file in order to enable the control port option. Later we will see that, for example, for connecting from Python, we will use this port for establishing the communications, the SOX port, using the SOX port. Basically, you need to create a tunnel that allows to connect the hidden services with an arbitrary port on the local machine using the SOX proxy raised by the Tor instance. With default configuration, the Tor client will listen on two ports, the 9050 for proxying connectivity and 9051 for accepting control commands from external programs like Python, for example. Here we can see more details the starting process, where we can see the different steps for Tor initialization for establishing a circuit. In the first step, we can see that it's connecting to the directory server, later establishing an encrypted directory connection, and finally what is that is load authority circuits and relay descriptors before establishing the Tor circuit. Well, this is another command for checking, for example, the verify the status of the connection, for example. Well, for connecting with Tor, I will use Python. We have some alternatives for connecting, for using in a programmatic way with Python. Stem is the library that we will use for get information for the Tor instance that is running in your local machine. Basically, it's a library, a module writing in Python to control a Tor instance programmatically and get information about relays. The other one is using, for example, a Tor request. Tor request basically is a wrapper between stem and the request library, the request module in Python. And the other alternative is using the combination request plus a SOX file. We have three alternatives. Well, now I am going to comment starting with stem. Stem is the main library written in Python to perform various operations against Tor clients and directory authorities. Basically, it's used to interact with the Tor controller, with the Tor instance, sending and receiving commands from the Tor control port programmatically. For example, we can use the signal method. It provides an API for get information. But for example, we can use the signal method to get a new identity and establish a new circuit. What kind of information we can obtain with STEM? Well, this is all the information that we can get. For example, each repeater in the Tor network expose information related to network Tor network clients in documents called descriptors. These files are distributed by authoritative entities in the Tor network. There are different types of descriptors depending the node relay type. Later we will see this aspect. STEM in the STEM spec we can see all parameters, all configurations with more details. But basically, STEM allows to obtain descriptors from authoritative directories and other relays in the Tor network. In the official specification, we can see a case for access specific information like for the Tor connection, information like version, configuration files, query status, configuration options, events, and so on. This is for connecting with the Tor network from Python, we can use the controller class from stem.control package. For example, you can set your password in an authenticate method. This password is configured in the Tor receive file configuration that we have seen before. And we can use, in this example, we can see that we are using the signal method for establish a new identity, a new connection, and renew your identity, your IP address. The following script, for example, auto-rotates the IP periodically every 20 seconds. For example, switching Tor circuit programmatically can be very useful, for example, for where doing tasks related with web scrapping and pen testing tasks. We can use this script for rotating your IPs and avoid IP banning and so on from when you are doing, for example, web scrapping. In this script, we can see that we are connecting with the port that is listening the commands. STEM provides also other classes that allows programmatically access to the Tor descriptors. For example, using the getInfo method of the Tor controller class, we can see the circuit status. And using, for example, the get network statuses, we can get information about the status of the Tor network. We can create, for example, an script for that is responsible for listing all the circuits created by the Tor instance. In your local machines, you will have your Tor instance. And all information that you can get with this script is allocated in your Tor installation, in your Tor configuration. And you can create a script but for listing all this information, the circuits created by the Tor instance in real time with their respective nodes. To do this, you can simply execute the get circuits method from the controller class, and well, basically it's very simple to get information in this way. And this is the output, this is the information that obtained the previous script we can see all the information for each circuit. This is the list of the circuits, and for each circuit we can see information about the IP address, the name of the circuit, and so on. Another way to obtain information from service descriptors is using the getServerDescriptor method. In this case, each server descriptor is an instance of the relay descriptor class. For example, we can use the getHidden service descriptor method for obtaining more information about onion address, like the IP address is related and identified for each async point. In this case, in this example, we are obtaining information about a specific onion address and what are the introduction points related with this address. Well, another interesting tool that we can install for monitoring all this information in real time is Nix. Nix is a command line tool monitor for Tor Network, and you can install it for Python repository. This is the information that provides this tool. With this tool, you can get detailed real time information about relays, such as bandwidth usage, events, logs, and connections. Connection data is similar to the nested or top commands that we can find in Unix systems, but the information is correlated with the Tor relays information. Also, this tool offers the possibility to visualize the connections that are established from the Tor instance, optional configuration of the instance, and the contents of the Tor RC file configuration. This is an output of Tor configuration where we can see the parameters associated with the Tor instance. There are a lot of information. In this video, for example, we can see the previous scripts. You can see the scripts. These scripts also are available in my personal GitHub repository. La de la old comment. Well, basically we can see the execution of these scripts with Python. In this case, we can see that we have defined a getTor session method for establishing the communication with the SOX file proxy. This is the first one for getting a new identity, rotating IP address, for example. In this order, we are obtaining information about server descriptors. This is all information with the public and private key of each server. This is another one for get information about Tor descriptors. These are the Tor descriptors. The first Tor descriptors. Relay connections. All the connections that are needed for connecting. Some utilities. This is the script where we can see the introduction points for a specific onion address. We get the server's introduction points. And this finally, this is the Nix tool for monitoring in real time the servers and the communication between nodes. And with these tools also we can get the Tor RC file configuration. This is one of the most complete tools for checking the state of your Tor instance and in general the Tor configuration in your local machine. Well, and for example, this is the second option that we have using, for example, the Tor request. The Tor request basically is a Python interface for HTTP or HTTPS request over Tor. The Tor request object expose the underlying Steam controller that we have seen before. And request session objects for more flexibility. It's basically a wrapper, an interface around Steam and request modules. Well, at this point, the question is how we can analyze this service and extend information programmatically. Well, the first step, for example, is analyze main shared engines that Tor provides for realize our queries. In the second step, for example, filter addresses that are active is important because Tor, as I commented before, Tor addresses change very quickly in the time. And if you see that an address is active, maybe 50 minutes or 10 minutes later the address is not active, and it's very important to check continuously the state of onion addresses before connecting. Also you can for example it's important check always the response of these addresses. Also, for example, we can store URLs in a file or database for control what URLs are processed and discard those that no response in a specific time. Also, we can get specific techniques, for example, performing a crawling process against each service. Well, at this point, I'm going to comment what are the OSIN tools that we have. OSIN framework provides many links related with tools oriented for OSIN or pen testing tasks. One of the most known shell engines that we have is Admia. It's a shell engine that works, for example, this work in, if you are connecting within the internet, in the surface web, and in the tunnel world. And you can use this shell engine for find active .onion sites. Other of the shell engines is Torch. Torch is another of the most popular shell engines in tunnel world. And Underdim shell engine also is another service. For example, from Python, for Discover Hidden Services, we can create a simple script. In the first method, getTorchSession, we establish the proxysocks, as we have seen before. We establish a proxysocks connection with the request.session method. And we can define our share method, where establish the criteria of the search and establish the pages for each request by setting specific criteria. In this case, we are searching with the Bitcoin string. At this point, for example, we can develop a script which purpose is the search of hidden services in a tunnel world and crawling the links obtained. Basically, the scripts use the request and proxy socks for establishing the connection with the Tor instance, and beautiful soup and for extracting links or specific information that are implementing a crawling process for extracting links for its higher services. The idea is that we can change the URL. Below we can see we can change this URL, the seed query URL, and use the share engine that we want. We can use Amia, Torch, or the shell engine that we want. In our main program, we can define patterns like shared number of results and some crawl options related with crawling of links or crawl information if not get no links. And for each link extracted, for example, we could verify if the URL, if the address is valid or not. Is a valid onion address or not. If it's a valid address, then we can add this link, this URL in a vector and an array for keeping track of those URLs that have been processed. There are other tools that we can use for discover hidden services. For example, PubPack is an experimental application for crawling, scanning and data gathering from Tor hidden services. Another like Tor Spider and Tor Router. Tor Spider is basically a scraper made in Python with beautiful soup and Tor support with Stem. Well, another other service that we can use for search onion addresses is this is the last service that is created for search onion addresses. That search is the last, as I comment, and you can view this search engine on any web browser. But you will only follow the links found in index by a Tor connection. This search engine is similar to Amia search engine. both Amia and that search both provides results directly accessible on the internet thanks to the Tor to web connection. The main difference between Dark Search and Amnia is that Dark Search provides an API, a free API to automate the searches with some limitations to avoid denied of service for avoid attackers and so on. Dark Search, as I comment, provides an IP for automating the search process. As we can see, the web today provides has almost half a million indexes pages in this engine. Basically, this IP provides an endpoint that allows you to query in this engine. And to avoid denial of service or this kind of attacks, the API is limited to 30 queries per minute. This is an example of query and response. The main advantage of this same engine is that we don't need to be connected to the Tor network for getting the first result. Only evidently if we want to apply a crawling process for follow links or get all the information, we need to connect to a Tor network. But at the first line for the first result, we don't need to connect the Tor network. And we in this script we can see that in a simple way we can use this endpoint for getting information. We are using, for example, the request and JSON modules from Python for obtain. We make a fixed request for obtain the pages of the information is get from the JSON object document, and for each page get we iterate for each page for get all links of these of all the specific search. We have more tools like Onion Investigators. Onion Investigators scans for alternative service that hidden service on Tor networks may run and maps out the web technologies used by specific Onion site. Statistics of this tool offers information about total scan Onion sites and web technologies and servers they are running. For example, we can obtain, we can get all Onion sites that are running an Nginx server, for example. Another interesting tool, for example, if we want to check if an Onion site is active or inactive, we can use, for example, Onion off for inspect specific web links. Basically, it's a Python script for inspecting deep web URLs. And at low level, is using the same libraries that we have seen before: Beautiful Soup, Request, PSOX, Python modules. Many times, you are checking a list of Onion sites that are not responding. And with this tool, you can check the state of a specific Onion site before sending the request. And we can see that it returns if the site is active or not. There are other tools, for example, other advanced tools like Torbot, that these tools are oriented to extract information using crawling techniques. Torbot is an open source intelligent for the dark web, and basically has a list of features that makes it useful for multiple applications. Features include Onion Crawler, returns a page title and address with a description about the site, get emails for a specific Onion site, save all crawl information can be saved in a JSON file. You can customize your crawling process. And the last one I'm going to comment in is this Onion Nmap. Docker Onion Nmap is a tool based with a Docker image. Basically, you can scan Onion hidden services with Nmap using Tor proxy chains and DNS Max with an Alpine Docker container. And when the container starts, throw Tor and DNS Max as daemons inside the Docker container. And we can see if for a specific Onion address, the ports open, close, and so on. And this is another tool that we can use. For example, Onion Scan is a free and open source developed tool in GoLang for investigating in the dark web. For example, Onion Scan has two primary goals. The first one is find security issues in hidden services. For example, detect misconfigurations and get server information. Also allows researchers and investigators monitor and track dark websites. And the last tool, for example, this is an interesting tool. Basically provides a visualization of the structure of the Tor Onion services in a graphical way. How the relation between it create what the tool what is that is creating a cluster of Onion sites, and each cluster contains Onion sites with relations between them with similar features are joined in a cluster. And that's all. This repository contains some of the tips about Tor Network and how to use it with Python scripts. And this is my personal GitHub repository where we can see the Python script that we have seen before for getting information with Steam libraries and other scripts for discover hidden services with Seven Giants. And that's all. Thank you.